State legislative leaders will appear on Arizona Horizon each month during the legislative session to talk about bills and other issues at the Capitol. And here now is Senate President Steve Pierce and Speaker of the House Andy Tobin. Good to see both again.
Thank you.
Good to be here.
Let's start with the budget and where you guys stand on the budget, and then we'll try to figure out if the governor's in the same ballpark. Where do you stand?
We have the budget. We have numbers that we put together, presented to her. We have met with her, and we're just trying to get our staff to work with her staff and start moving along.
What, as far as numbers are concerned, what does the budget have to come in at? Where does it have to come in? And where does that differ from the governor's?
Well, I think you first have to understand that there's an awful lot of pressures that we're not in control of down here. I mean, we're still looking at Obamacare moving forward. Hopefully, the federal government is going to start tightening their belt. That's going to reduce some funds going to the states. So our members are fearful about what that means, not just getting by the sales tax going away, but what that means in year 14 or 15. I applaud the President, the Senate, and our members of the House. They're trying to take a look at this as if they're running a business, and they're saying, okay, what does this look like? Not just for this year, when it's convenient. What's it look like for next year? We haven't been down there to have a good time with the budget. We've always been cutting the thing. Mm-hmm. So we're trying to make sure that we don't have to come back to where we've been, and I think that's our members are being very cautious about the spending. I guess we're still about $800 million. I think that's probably the difference before we start negotiating.
And like Andy said, we did do projections out to 2015, and that shows a $700 million deficit without additional spending. So we're just trying to be cautious, and that's a long ways out to plan, but we're just trying to be cautious, make sure that we have everything covered. We don't want to go back to where we've been.
The idea of, I've heard this before, the line, no cuts, no restorations, no sweeps. Is that viable?
It is for us, yes. And we just do not believe that you should take all the agency's money. There's $200 million there to be swept, and then tell them you can go back out and you can raise rates on people and raise fees. That isn't right. We just don't need to spend the money. There's other things we can do.
Other things to do?
Well, there are, but I mean, I think what the President's saying is we're trying to make sure that there's some stability in a government budget. And, the revenues are there right now, but we want to make sure that we're looking at it. That's a carry forward. We're not looking at these surplus dollars. We're saying this is carry forward money, and the whole idea is to make sure that as we move forward, there might be some places we miss things. We're all fine with going ahead and starting a route review. Maybe we made a mistake. Maybe we missed a few things. And let's go back and look at those and see what we have to put back. But to further reduce a lot of these agencies isn't on the table, and sweeping them isn't on the table for us right now either. So.
You were quoted, though, a couple of things that the governor's office at one point was not being very cooperative. And at another point, she may not understand, or her folks may not understand, your caucus. What your caucus is interested in may not have the same strength there on the ninth floor. Talk to us about that.
Well, my caucus is very conservative, and we are more cautious. We just want to make sure we have money there when the time comes that we need it. The cliff that we're talking about in 2014, well, the 1 cent sales tax goes away, and then Obamacare could be kicking in. Access is going to be costing us more money, and we're going to have to be prepared. We have to have a lot of money set aside ready for that. In our budget that we presented, we have money set aside. There's a rainy day fund, and then there's other funds that we'd like to wait until May of next year to allocate them, so we can see what happens with the election, what happens with Obamacare, with some lawsuits, and then maybe we can use it.
Last question on this, the idea of the governor maybe wanting some sweeps, maybe wanting to buy back the capital expenditures along these lines. Is there a disconnect there? What's going on?
Well, I think it goes back to the same point. We're trying to make sure we're paying down debt every month as it is. And that doesn't mean, none of us want to have this debt there. But if we hit those points down the road where maybe interest rates have gone up and we've already paid down some debt that we wanted to, but the interest rates are higher, and now we're running into these pressures that I spoke about with the feds, we may have to go back to the till and borrow again. And the members have done it before, then they really are cautious. They don't want to find themselves in that position again. Neither do I. This is the best budget negotiation we've ever been in. I mean, I know it's
That's
February,
right.
But for heaven's sakes, we made all the tough choices together a year ago. It gave us a chance to get Arizona on the right footing, so I'm sure we'll be able to find a way.
We'll get through it.
Yeah.
We have a good relationship with the governor.
One of those tough choices made in the past involved enrollment freeze for access, and the Arizona Supreme Court today basically did not decide to review, and they're not going to look at it, so it basically stands as it is. I want to ask you the same question I asked when the debate was strong, and I'm still hearing from critics of this move. Is this good for Arizona? Is this good for Arizona's economy?
Well, we have to do what we can afford. I think it is. If we had gone ahead and had not done this, no telling, we'd be in worse shape now than we are. Andy's mentioned that the surplus people talk about, that isn't a surplus. That money's already spent. We're in the hole already the way we are. There are people that probably need to be covered. There are things we need to look at. We probably need to restore some parts of access. But no, you know, we did the right thing. It was a hard decision, but look where we are now. We're talking about a surplus that really isn't a surplus.
But 100,000 childless adults losing coverage. Again, if they wind up going to hospitals, they're already saying they're feeling it, and they're going to feel it even more now. Good for Arizona. And again, if those folks lose their coverage, is that good for the economy?
Well, I think we have to look where we're going. You have one in five people in access. I mean, it's not sustainable. Any business that's out there would be able to share that. You know, how do you sustain that? Your options is to raise taxes. That's not going to create a job. You know, so we're trying to have a fair balance in here and make sure that the dollars get to those folks who are the most at need. And, you know, it wasn't easy making some of these reductions, but calling for us to go back to a place where we've just come from, you know, which bled the state dry for the overspending we have is not something that the legislature is going to tolerate moving forward. And neither is this governor. So I'm not saying these aren't difficult choices, but the best thing we can do is get jobs moving. That takes people off of access. That takes people, you know, they get into the paying mode. They're starting to buy things. And I think the economic packages we're looking at moving is going to help with that.
The governor's personnel plan is very important to her. Obviously mentioned it during her State of the State speech. And it sounds like now it's been introduced. What took so long with this?
Well, we had things we had to do first. Our obligation down here, our constitutional duty is to come down and pass a balanced budget. And that's what we've been working towards is the budget. Then she wants that done. We are moving it. She asked Andy and I 2 weeks ago to get it moving, and we did. We had it in our caucus last week. Andy had it in the House last week, and then it was introduced today. So we are moving ahead on that. And there isn't a lot of opposition to it. There's parts that need to be tweaked, but it's not there isn't a lot of opposition.
Well, Representative Olson is in testimony as we speak right now. You know, the legislature's in session. We're moving along. Representative Robson has countered the bill in the House, and so we're having that debate as we speak. And we're happy to bring that to the governor's table. So
last question: anti-union measures. These are getting a lot of attention here. Where are they? Where do they stand?
I think I have to go to the Senate.
One bill was passed out today. The other three are sitting. They're still being worked with members. There's discussions on them. I don't know if they're going to get out all four of them or not, but they've moved some.
Okay, so we're hearing reports maybe that the ban on collective bargaining might be in for some tough sledding over there.
I think it probably will be, but again, my caucus is a real conservative caucus. I will have to wait and see where we go on it. It's not really appropriate at this time to say, hey, they're all going forward or they're not. But I know one was passed out, the one on paycheck protection, 1484, was passed out today, so out of Cal. So,
okay.
I take it back. Then we voted on it, too. We did it all today, and it was voted on, passed out. I think we had 19 votes for it.
All right. We'll stop it right there. Gentlemen, good to have you here. Thanks for joining us. We appreciate it.
Well, thank you.
Good to see you.